Our today's service was indeed a blessed and a divine one. We are indeed privileged to have His Grace, Zakaria Mann Nikolaos, our Assistant Metropolitan of the Diocese of America, our beloved Kochi Tirumeni. He's going to be our next speaker.
Reverend Fathers, dear brothers and sisters, just looking at the watch, it took almost as much time as the Holy Qurbana for the media. So first let me thank all those who didn't come for giving their speeches. Sometimes I think when you walk into a church, you get into a trap. Once you get in, they won't let you go out. Kuttanad area, we have the fishing trap. So it's a very easy, very simple looking trap. But once the fish gets in, it is impossible for the fish to walk out. So people come to the church in the hope that they have a peaceful Holy Qurbana, have the communion and leave. But we wouldn't let them. It is not, I say this, it is not because it is inappropriate to remember our ancestors, especially the important people who have taught us the faith. But the greatest memorial we could give was just done. So sometimes the way we conduct the meetings belittle that big event we just celebrated. Because the Eucharist we offered was the greatest thanksgiving that is possible on earth. So do we have to sit together and say repeatedly? And we are here because we know these people were great. We love them. And we continue to love them. So it is my suggestion that at least in the next year, let the Holy Eucharist be a simple Eucharist so that we can remember these people, especially, I think if Munduriyachan was here, it would not have happened. He would have been more appropriate about these things. And I'm not trying to scold over it. What I'm saying is, we forget the important thing in our eagerness to express our thanks to our departed people or loved ones, or in our eagerness to express our love. But it shouldn't be at the cost of more important things. So just let us focus on the greatest thanksgiving we offer. We are, as repeatedly the speakers have said, we are remembering three great people who played their own important roles in the history of the church at different levels. As we listened to the gospel, they said that those who served according to the talents, or whom the Lord finds that done their job well, will be rewarded properly. So we are celebrating those people who did their job with the utmost efficiency and carefulness which they could. And now, if we love and respect and want to remember them properly, let us go out and do likewise. It is easy for us to come here, say a few words and go back. But then come back again next year. And if you collect, or now there is a video recording, maybe if you, a replay of the same event next year, almost you can hear the same words. But in between you don't see any change in the people. So let us focus on that. If we take these people, Pambadi Tirumeni, Makkariya Tirumeni and Munduriyachan, whom we remember seriously, let us do what
Your Grace, our beloved Kochi Triveni, respected members of the clergy, elders, friends. Christ is risen. In tune with what Triveni just told us, I should not speak long, I will not speak long. I just wanted to note that it is my great privilege to propose this vote of thanks for the three great personalities who have had great impact on the lives of so many of us, and personally me. It's a great privilege for me to stand here before you representing my parish and other parishes, also online communities like ICON, where Mundu Uriyachin was such a great contributor and supporter, and also as a personal friend. Let me move quickly towards my responsibilities. I thank our beloved Kochi Triveni for being present with us today, for leading us in the Holy Eucharist, and for chairing this memorial service. I thank Father Stefanos of the Armenian Orthodox Church for his kind words and for allowing us the use of this place. Thank you, Father. I thank all the children who took the time and effort to prepare and speak on this occasion. I thank Christina, Karthi, Justin, Tommy, Marley. Thank you and good job. Let me thank Mrs. Leelama Thomas, who worked so closely with Achan, for her kind words. Thank you, Mr. Philippos Philip, for representing the Sabha Managing Committee in this meeting and for your kind words. I thank Mr. Varghese Sathimootil for representing Albany Parish for your kind words. Thank you. All thanks is also due to our Job Sanachan, who behind the scenes was always there to keep asking us if everything is going according to plan. Thank you so much, Achan. Finally, I thank each one of you for your presence here this morning to grace this occasion on behalf of my parish, on behalf of Mundu Uriyachin's family, and all parishes in Syracuse, Kingston, Toronto, and all places where Achan served. I thank everyone for your participation and encouragement today. Thank you, and Christ is indeed risen. Just a few announcements. After this, after Kaimuthal, there are a few more programs. We are planning to go to the cemetery. There will be prayers offered at the tomb of Mundu Uriyachin. So the directions to cemetery, back to the church, will be provided during Kaimuthal. There is a lunch refreshments planned here. And those who, I know many people here want to go and visit Mundu Uriyachin's home and to meet the latest addition to Mundu Uriyachin's family, Angeli Mary Thomas. So directions are also provided from the church to Mundu Uriyachin's home. As you leave, taking the Kaimuthal and proceed to the cemetery, there will be Nercha Neyyappam that will be offered. Also, another thing is on the 14th of April, there is a memorial service for Mundu Uriyachin at Syracuse Parish, where Achan served for so long. We welcome you, invite you.